to be a lot of people. Yeah. It's just if you be with it and obedient.
Amen.
See, the relationship is between you and God.
Yes, it is. Yes, I am.
And God is precise.
Thank you, God.
You understand what I mean? Them eyes, you got them your eyes, and these my eyes. God is precise. He's not going to give me your blessing.
All right, man.
Since they say he's gonna open and pull it out the window, I really didn't think he's gonna miss it. Get blessed the wrong person or something. God is precise.
Amen.
So be not deceived. God is not mine. But I am a man, so that shall he also read. And he said, he has sown to his flesh. You understand that everything was about me, myself, and I, stuff and things. Y'all ain't got to say that. Everything was about me, myself, and I, and stuff and things. He has sown to the flesh. Some of the flesh we corrupt. Doesn't matter what you're doing, doesn't matter what you get in life. And eventually, you're going to have to leave this world, and you can't take it with you. Because scripture says, you brought nothing in this world. And it is certain we can carry nothing out. And if you trust your wife by what you have, when you don't have nothing, you won't be worth it. But God got to say that I'm a rich in God, and all that I need is in God. And if I never have money, as long as I'm the one who made the one that made the money, as long as I got to. Zacharias said to the angel, whereby shall I know this? And you know the angel Gabriel didn't plan to identify himself. You understand, I'm not just a boy down the street. I'm not no make-believe prophet, but I'm Gabriel, the one that stand and talk with God. And God told me to tell you that you're going to have a child. Then since you didn't believe that you're going to become dumb and not be able to speak until the child is born. Sometimes I'll be questioning God. God, show me a sign. Show me God so I can know. Sometimes you don't want what God gonna use to show you. Zacharias knew that before he went into the temple, he was able to speak. But when he came out, the Bible said he wasn't able to speak. They thought he was drunk. Because his mouth was moving. Wasn't coming out. The angel was precise and told him that you're going to name the child John. And he's going to be the forerunner of the Savior that was to come. And he said he's going to come in the spirit of Elijah. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make straight the path of the Lord. You understand that? We can see now that God loves us enough. And that God is equipped to our cry. And no matter who you are, if you receive the Lord, you will accept it. But the devil wants to break our minds. The devil wants to tell us that God is not real. The devil wants to tell us that all these things are a waste of time. The devil and the naysayers, y'all ain't saying that. The atheists want to tell us that God is not real. And I don't have to study it. I don't have to go to school for it. I know I've had an experience with God. But I'm not just talking about something that happened since then. But I've had an experience with God. God speaks to my heart and lets me know that he is real. You gotta know for yourself that God is real. But you must understand that the angel spake to Gabriel. And even with an angel speaking to him, He still had doubt.
Right.
And you know what I know, that I'm not an angel. You understand that I be, but I cry, I'm telling you the truth.
Yeah.
And you want to know how you can know,
yeah,
it's all in the word, yeah, of the Lord.
Yeah.
But this word says everybody must be born again.
Yeah.
You understand, God created us, but he said we got to be born again. You got to be changed from the person you are now into the person that God wants you to be. And many of us are trying to live the life that God requires, but have not had a change of heart. Zechariah was the only one who questioned the angel for a sign. Abraham had the same experience. You remember Abraham, 9 years old.
Yeah.
The angel saying, your wife is going to have a son. Not only will she have a son, but your seed is going to be innumerable.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And Abraham, the Bible says, his wife lay. And Abraham doubted, saying, how is it that a man of my old age is going to have some faith?
Yeah.
I don't care how old you are. God is able to do impossible. That is good for me. Things are impossible. But with God, all are possible.
Thank you, God.
You remember Moses?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. At the burning bush.
Yeah.
Who too saw an angel.
Amen.
Who called him for God.
Yeah.
And Moses also wanted a sign. And Moses made excuses, and Moses asked God, who shall I tell them to send me? And he said, just tell them that I am, that I am, that I have sent you. And Moses, you don't have to tell Pharaoh where God lives. I know God's address, and I don't know his phone number. But every time I call him, he'll always hear.
Yeah.
When he wakes you up in the morning,